Hi, my name is Pulkit Tandon, and I'm a student at Stanford University. Today, I'm going to be talking about our work on Txt2Vid, ultra-low bitrate compression of talking head videos via text. So videos are basically everywhere, with video streaming making 80% of today's internet traffic. COVID-19 has led to an even bigger boom with tools like Zoom seeing a surge in usage. But unfortunately, we have limited access to bandwidth worldwide. And these audio-video calls can take anywhere from 100 kilobits per second to a few megabits per second. So I'm sure all of us have been in one of these Zoom calls, which is a modern rendition of Alice and Bob conversing, where Alice is trying to talk with Bob on a video call. And at some point, Alice basically sees Bob's freezing and asks Bob to turn off the video. And at that point, even though Alice can hear everything what Bob is saying, she still wishes like they could have seen each other while having this call. So the thought which this led to is, wouldn't it be nice to have like audio video calls at lower bandwidth? And one observation which we had is that if instead of streaming videos, we were just streaming audios, we could have gotten a 10x improvement in the compression, like 10x less bits to transmit. And with text, we could even get much higher advantage of the order of 2 to 3 orders of magnitude. So basically we have this 100 to 1000x compression opportunity. And the question which we end up asking is, can we compress this audio video content generated via webcams to just text? But how will you evaluate such a study? So the traditional focus for metric is on single sample fidelity. So like either you look at single video pixel or audio sample. The recent trend in the community is to move towards more perceptual metrics such as VMAC. But unfortunately, there is no perceptual metric for audio and video experience combined as of now. And naively thinking, you might feel that videos are more important, but that's not always true. In fact, this is a screenshot from the Demuxed recording guide. And what we see there is that they're basically saying that quality audio is way more important than quality speaker video. So basically, what we really need to characterize is this combined audio-video experience. And what we decided in our work is to focus on just the overall quality of experience which you get out of these audio-video streams. So in the end, the question we end up asking is that, can we compress AV content, audio-video content, generated via webcams to just text and recover videos with similar quality of experience when you compare them to standard codecs in a low bitrate regime? And we answer the question in affirmative. And let me not build the suspense, and let's just show you some of the examples of the decoded videos.
Although I'm going to talk about banning artifacts. Banning artifacts are artificially introduced contours arising from the quantization of a smooth region in a video.
Let me show you guys another example.
Hello, I'm going to talk about banning artifacts. Banning artifacts are artificially introduced contours arising from the quantization of a smooth region in a video.
So both of these videos were basically rated similar quality of experience in a subjective study we performed. But the video on the top is basically just 100 bits per second text stream, which was decoded using Txt2Vid, whereas the video in the bottom is basically 100,000 bits per second AV stream, which was encoded and decoding using H.264 for videos and AAC for audios. And you can see there is a 1000x benefit in this case. So how does this Txt2Vid approach work? So in a conventional system, you have a sender which basically transmits a video and audio stream separately, which is then recovered at the receiver, combined and displayed to the consumer. The stream is typically of the order of 100 kilobits per second. In Txt2Vid approach, like, we take this approach slightly differently. We try to recreate the video using the prior of a human. Like, there is not much happening in these videos when you have a person actually talking through the webcam. So what we do as a one-time operation is basically we extract a driving video from the user, and then we send this driving video, which is just a short 30-second clip along with user ID, to be stored at the decoder site. So this is just a one-time operation. But during typical usage of this pipeline, we basically take the speech, we convert it into text, and basically all we transmit is this text stream along with a user ID, which is used to identify the driving video for this particular user. On the decoder side, you basically get this text, you convert it into speech using a text-to-speech software, which is then lip-synced to an existing driving video so as to give the impression as if the person was speaking the same words. And these two are combined to basically give you the final audio-video experience at the receiver side. So the two main softwares in the decoder pipeline which we use is this text-to-speech and the lip syncing. So in a performance evaluation, even though the decoder components can be anything, we decided to go with these two particular tools. So we use resemble.ai for text-to-speech. The main salient feature of Resemble is that you can basically record few samples, and then it regenerates a voice. It basically regenerates a voice clone of yours, which is very similar to the voice characteristics of an individual. We use Wave2Lip for lip syncing, which is an open source software, which basically syncs an audio to the lip so that it seems as if the person is speaking that audio in the video. For evaluation, we had to create a data set. Our data set basically had six contents and then three different kinds of encodings. The first one was including the H.264 for encoding the videos and AAC for encoding the audios. Four different qualities of H.264s were combined with two different qualities of AAC to give like total of eight videos. Similarly, we also compared with AV1 as a video codec, just to compare with one of the most state-of-the-art video codecs. And similarly, we had like six such audio video content, six such audio video streams per content. And finally, we also had a Txt2Vid stream where you are basically just transmitting a BZIP to compressed text. So eventually, we basically try to compare these 84 benchmark audio videos with six Txt2Vid audio videos, and we only evaluate the decoder. So the subjective study we performed was using Qualtrics and Amazon MTurk. We basically showed two randomized videos, one from the benchmark set, the other from the Txt2Vid set, and we just asked the user for their preference, like which video do they prefer. Our subjective study involved 242 participants, and there were approximately 40 subjects per comparison. And then to show the results, so this is like a plot which we get for like six different contents. Let's maybe focus on one content, this content one. On the x-axis, basically, as you go towards the right, the compression ratio for the text-to-vid approach increases. On the y-axis, as you go up, you basically have a higher preference for the text-to-vid video than the benchmark video. And then finally, we focus on this 50% mark, which is basically the equal quality of experience mark. And for this content, basically, you get approximately 1000x compression benefit. And what we see is basically over various contents, there is an approximately 1000x compression at ISO quality. This is not true for all the contents. There were some contents where we had lower preference. For more details, I would ask you, we can take it offline. Similarly, we can also compare. So the last comparison was between H.264 and AAC, but we can also compare against AV1 and AAC. And in this case, we saw that there is 200x compression because AV1 is a much better video encoder. So far, we have only just considered the performance of the decoding video, but let me show you guys a streaming demo. So now we are going to give a demonstration of a streaming pipeline through Txt2Vid. On my side, I'll be typing text through the terminal. And for this demonstration, I have my friend Shubham helping me out. So Shubham is going to receive this text and then use the Txt2Vid decoder to decode the audio video from the text. So let's try it out. So I'm going to mute myself now so that you don't hear the audio twice.
Hello. How is it going? I hope it's going good. This is a demonstration of our streaming pipeline. I hope it works. I think it did. Awesome. Talk to you later then, bye.
So as you guys could probably see in the streaming demo, there are certain limitations of our current implementation. So some of them include, on the decoder side, we basically have this high computational complexity, and there's a current reliance on cloud-based APIs. But this is not a fundamental problem. As we envision, there are improvements in hardware, more open source deep learning models, as well as edge computing can alleviate these issues. There are some more slightly fundamental issues with the pipeline, which is regarding the latency and the quality of experience. And then again, for latency, like this is, I want to highlight the streaming prototype is just one of the first prototypes we came up with. There are many avenues of improvement using better software engineering or real-time protocols. And for quality of experience, you can envision like we can start training custom models where we can also include emotion of a speaker as metadata, and we cover that on the video side. Finally, there are some ethical and privacy concerns, which is just social acceptance and safety while using such a technology. And though one can envision usage of encryption in such a case, but this is something which we should think about as a community with more involvement of ML. Finally, I would like to highlight there are just like lots of application of such a technology. You can imagine just talking with your friend, even at low bandwidth or in remote terrains. And finally, you can also imagine learning pedagogical content with just your favorite teacher. And I would say this is an awesome opportunity to get more involved. This is just the first work. We have a code on GitHub, and there is also a more detailed paper on archive for technical details. Finally, I would just like to thank all my collaborators. Particularly, I would like to thank Shubham and Pat for their help with this presentation. Thank you.